My intro for you. Hi, I'm Ani Kyd, and this is Radio Hell. Now, the song's called Six California Dollars.
Delegate. I'm the
there I'll have to come up with something witty. My mind's asleep, worn and clean, but much too late. Time to retaliate. The hand of fate.
Yeah.
Yeah. Music in between, everybody. Alright, so switching of the guitars. Okay, now I'm going to get on my electric beast. That was the acoustic moment. Not very acoustic, but it's definitely the acoustic moment.
What's the new adornment?
What?
The new adornment.
Oh, jeez, and you're going to ask me. This is, it says, Hickson Fire Department. And that's because I stole it from the Hickson Fire Department. Because I live in Hickson now, and Evan knows that. He just thinks it's funny. Hickson is 65K away from Prince George and 65K away from Quesnel. So it's right in the middle of hell. Radio hell. Sorry, I'm plugging the show constantly. Okay, this song's called Rejoice. This is a song that's off of my first release on Alternative Tentacles in 2005 called Evil Needs Candy 2. And there's usually like a band in the background, but you can imagine. Just imagine. Imagine. Okay. Yeah, we're having lots of fun here. Ben has left the building. He's had enough. You guys are driving me crazy. Okay, here you go. Rejoice.
Once I was young and naive, that's where you wanted me. And you fuck with and toy and ruin everything. Couldn't even leave me alone and let me walk my high. I had to fill my head with the most ruthless
I'm here for good.
just your wife.
Guitar, and where are we at? Forget the time, guys.
Tons of time.
Tons of time, Ben says. So the next will be Annie's comedy moment after this, because you know I do need to leave some cool songs for like the show that I'm playing next week at the Emerald on Thursday night, Thursday the 24th at the Emerald, and then Friday at the Railway Club. The 25th. So if you're not an Emerald person and you don't want dinner, then you go into the Railway Club and you drink and party and hang out on your Friday night, right? And tomorrow night in Squamish. So, yeah, tomorrow night in Squamish.
Where are you playing in Squamish?
Squompton, man. Squompton.
Squompton, where are you playing?
Straight out of Squompton.
Yeah.
Where am I playing? At the How Sound Brew Pub? How Sound Brew? That's like a tongue twister, man. How Sound Brown Cow. Brew Club. Plub. So yeah, so I'm playing there. I sound like I'm drunk. I'm playing there tomorrow night, and it should be really eventful. I'm playing with Batty Fang. He's a solo artist also. Really awesome guy. Plays like sort of a bluesy slide guitar kind of thing too, with crazy effects on the voice and stuff, so it should be really good. He's playing at the Railway Club with me on the 25th, also in Vancouver. And the band Hollow Ground, they're great. Cheryl Catherine Smith and Ash Riot, one of the original Riot Girls, they're playing opening up at the Emerald. So yeah, if you want to catch one of those guys too, it should be pretty awesome. I better change guitar.
Changing guitars.
I still want to know about the world famous bar in Hicks, or in Wells, actually. Like, does it still look like it used
Which
to
one?
In the 70s, the Jack of Clubs?
Oh my god, it's so bizarre, dude. I just played Wells on the 5th of September, Wells, B.C., and it's like this crazy, like, gold rush town. Supposedly there was 3 banks in that tiny little town at one point. But yeah, it was pretty incredible. I think I'll be moving there next. I'm going to try all the small towns in British Columbia. And yeah, so it's so crazy looking. It has this really neat stage and it looks something right out of the 20s. It's pretty neat. But it's got this, it's got a general store now instead of where it was the casino part, and they're gonna build a restaurant. So it's almost ghost towny in a weird way. It's like a general store with like, you know, itchy bon noodles and like fleece jackets. The combination is a little wild. I was like, oh, okay. Do you have any guns and killing machines and lozenges, please? Because, you know, my throat hurts after killing. So it's pretty crazy, right? So It was fun. You should play a show with me, Evan, sometime. We should do a tour.
Okay. Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Solo tour.
Yeah, that'd be really cool.
So stay tuned for the Annie and Evan solo tour.
As long as we get to play the Jack Clubs.
All right, I'll book it.
Okay, cool.
All right. Can we do comedy in between?
Yeah.
So, Evan, tell me, how was your day? How do you know about Hickson, Evan?
How do I know about Hickson? Well, because it all started when my uncle worked for the forestry in Hickson, and he lived there, and I still remember my stepfather getting really, really drunk and having this big, long argument, sort of discussion, about how kids didn't choose to be born, and my mom wanted to drive home and leave me here.
See, I was asking Evan earlier when I was setting up a boat, sing the blues 4-7, and I was going to play a little song. He's like, I don't got anything to be upset about. Everything is great in life. It's awesome. Except that sounded pretty upsetting.
But it was over 40 years ago, so I'm over
40 years ago. I had a lot of therapy.
Yeah, actually, a lot of acupuncture therapy. It seemed
like. When they stab you with the needle, you're like, no, no! Stop the killing! Oh my god, yeah, see? Ben has left the building. It's like, okay, I don't want to have anything to do with you freaks anymore. Well, yeah, so I played Wells and I did some shows in Prince George. And the reason that I'm playing, B.C. is because I really want to throw this, solo tour thing out there and get people accustomed to me and my solo comedy, depressing song solo comedy, the bipolar action. And then, because I moved up there. Right? Isn't that why you were poking me about the Hickson Fire Department? That I stole that sticker. You put me right on radio telling everyone I stole a sticker.
Was it volunteer? Is it a volunteer fire?
Yeah, department? I volunteered to take that sticker.
Yeah, nice.
And then I put it on my guitar. It's sort of a little like, oh yeah, Hickson Volunteer Fire Department rules.
So what happens on Saturday nights then?
Oh, Saturday nights. Saturday Night Fireworks, babe. Saturday Night Fireworks. So this is a true story. Evan asked me, he knows the area, so he said, so do you ever get fireworks at cinema? And I'm like, oh my god, you've got to know the area to know that. Cinema's this tiny little town, sort of whatever it is, and it's a big store, and they sell fireworks 24 hours a day. Well, no, not 24. It's like 7 days a week. All year round, fireworks, all year round. And so I moved to Hickson in the middle of 65K between Quesnel and Prince George, the spot on the map, because it's beautiful there and I love it. And I moved there, and then, 2 days after I moved there, there's like all of a sudden these fireworks come out, like boom, boom, crazy, boom, boom. I'm like, what the hell is this? The radio, hell is this? And then so I wake up my boyfriend, who's very used to this place, and I said, Chris, what is this? What's going on here? And he said, Saturday Night Fireworks, babe. Saturday Night Fireworks. And I'm like, what? Is this legal? And he's like, yeah. I said, good happen on a Tuesday. Who knows, right? So it was like, it's a little crazy there. It's unincorporated. And the other day I was just sitting there drinking tea, and two horses ran up the street. And I was like, is that okay? Is this really what happens? And then people running after the horses. And that's definitely interesting. And people ride around on lawn tractors. That'll come later in the set. I'll tell you after I play this song, I'm going to play you a song about Hickson that I wrote while I was up there. Nice. Okay, so this song is now sad and depressing after all that comedy. This song is called Pray. P-R-A-Y, not P-R-E-Y, because that would be a little bit more like Hickson. One of my best friends up there now is a hunter, and she's really lovely. She's a hunter, and I'm a vegan, so we have this, like, don't talk about the hunting, don't talk about the veganism. Actually, she's quite lovely. and but she's on a killing spree right now. So they left, and I saw the caravan of trucks, and I was like totally terrified. Of like they're all excited to go on a killing spree. I was like, wow, burn it all. But hey, you know, live and let live. Oh, I gotta tune that. So talk amongst yourselves for a minute. So yeah, so there was this. What the hell? I'm really out of tune. Well, that's what happens when you're like touring by your lonesome in a Jeep. That's what I'm doing. Actually, I have a co-pilot. She's 6 pounds. Yeah, I can hear my guitar there. Yeah, she's 6 pounds and she's a Chihuahua. And she really loves touring. Actually, she hates it. Thinks it sucks, but. Oh well, here we go. I'm gonna go. So Evan, you got any of my stories about Prince George? We're not doing it.
Well, what I guess I want to know about like record stores.
Oh, in Hixson?
Well, no, record stores in Vancouver.
Like, you want to know
them? Yeah.
Oh, you want to know the story about I told you about Nardwar?
Yeah.
Okay, this is a Nardwar story. Well. Nardwar used to call me every time Jello Biafra came to town because he knew that Jello Biafra was staying at my house or was near me somewhere at some point, and we were hanging around. So Nardwar would call and be like, oh, hey, Annie, how's it going? Like, out of the blue, like, he just was like, oh, what's going on? So this is a long time ago, and because he wanted to interview Jello for the, I don't know, 94th time or something. So I would be like, oh, hey, Nardwar, how are you doing? Yeah, Jello's here. Do you want to take him out to record stores and, you know, go shopping with him? And he'd be like, yeah, because they are both, you know, two of the same when it comes to records. Like, they can, yeah, record geeks big time. They can spend, like, 7 hours. Like, I'd be taking a nap. I'd be like, this is too much for me, right? I can't handle it. So, but Nardwar, he's totally all in. He's totally all in. So I got him to take Jello. For me, which was really nice, and him and Jello had a lot of fun, and now they do it all the time, and it's a regular thing they do. They go to record stores and go, oh, is this the first release of the last release of the first cousin's album that only put out and has one hand and only put out, like, who knows, right? Like, I don't understand half of what they're talking about, so that's why I stay away. So yeah, so that's the Nardwar. Isn't that what you wanted to hear?
Yeah, thank you for sharing that.
Oh, okay. Was it actually, or are you just?
I don't know. Maybe it was just the dirty little secret.
Yeah, and now I told everybody, all 4 people listening. Jeez. He's like, actually, there's more than 4.
There's 26.
26? Uh-oh. Okay, this one's called Pray.
Thank you.
house. Trapped in their own mental wellness. For long life, there is reason. She's agoraphobic, recently diagnosed. Disorder, allergic to everything but toast. He's been medicated for many years. Stays at the walls, locked up with joy and tears. So much about Hickson, I gotta play Hickson song. So, what I'm gonna do is, I do this one song when we're playing at the, when I'm playing live, I do it a cappella to, not this Hickson song, that would just be too weird. I just gotta find it right there. I'm thinking, okay, I know you guys hear a paper shuffling and you're like, what is wrong with that woman? Anyway, the Hickson song is called My Baby is a Redneck, which I thought was pretty funny because it shows my humorous side. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just play that. I won't do the a cappella one because to come to the show and hear that, it's pretty interesting. But this one's fun. This is a sing-along that I get the whole audience in on. You get to really see my comedy. And so come and see me play all the set, all fun, all sad, all fun, all sad, back and forth. I take you on a roller coaster, an emotional roller coaster. I like to joke with you, and then I like to let you down and make you feel my pain. Thank you.
So remind everybody, when are you playing?
I'm playing at the Railway Club with Batty Fang, solo, another solo artist, on the 25th, which is a Friday, so that's party down drinking time, 25th at the Railway Club. Batty Fang, and then I'm playing the 24th, I'm going back, 24th with Hologram at the Emerald on Gore Street. Super cool place, great little dining, so check it out. And then Hologram is opening up, that one, Batty Fang is opening up on the 25th. And tomorrow, I'm playing at the How Now Brown Cow Brew Pub in Squamish. And so come and check that out too, How Sound Brew Pub. Thank you. And this song is called My Baby is a Redneck.
My baby is a redneck. He's gonna go to town and get himself a brand new pickup truck. Guns for country fun, chewing straw and drinking beer. On the trolley, going to town. My baby is a redneck. My baby is a redneck. My baby is a redneck. local home in a town called Hickson. It wasn't a big price, but it sure needed lots of fixing. Don't have lots of money, but sure we're happy.
Probably should be clarified. It is not spelled, even though you want it to be spelled H-I-C-K-S-O-N.
Oh.
It is actually spelled H-I-X-O-N.
Oh, all right. I'm glad you clarified that because I had no idea. But
thank God you're
thank you so much for coming out, Ani Kyd, playing next Thursday night at the Emerald,
yeah.
And Friday again at the Rotary Club. Should be tons of fun. Are you playing? Do you know if you're playing in the back room of the
Emerald? Yeah,
oh, yeah. The special party room.
The party room.
Yeah, that's where it is.
That's
yeah.
Where the cool people go.
That's where they, it's a really nice room. Have you been?
Yeah, I like
it's a very nice. It's a very nice room. So yeah, there should be a lot of should be a good time. Thanks, Evan, for filling in with sound and your commentary. It's fantastic. That's all the time we have. Coming up next, we have Copy Paste. Stick around. This is CITR 101.9 FM.